How you doing?
Okay, anybody else there yet?
Donna Friedman is ready to come in now.
See a picture there in the swimming pool.
I don't see a picture yet. I says joining over here.
Yeah, what is it? I think she's got a she's holding on to somebody. I can't make out. It's so small. Like
Dog. She has a dog usually.
a dog, maybe.
Mine says joining. I can't see her yet. Depends on where she's coming from. Sometimes she's in Canada, sometimes she's here. I sent you I think a message. I think I said Rabbi Schwartz would have never accepted your excuse last week that you couldn't find the link.
Rabbi Schwartz.
Would never have accepted it. It says you got a dollar to Shekhinah.
They said I couldn't find my place in
Well,
the
we extrapolate to this.
Yeah.
I can't see the daughter yet. Mine says joining. You see her?
No, all I see is Donna Friedman and that little picture.
Well, it says joining. It says I can't even see a picture yet.
Well, actually, for the past few years, you've been putting the link both on Facebook and
Email.
on the email.
Yeah, I've been trying. Yeah, I've been trying. I want to make sure everybody can find it.
Well, the email, I know, but now you don't have it on the email because when I put in Salzella, Boca, Zoom, or
I said you're on the email list. MAGewirtz@AOL.com. You're on the email list. You
yeah,
get
but I could. I last week I didn't even look for it today on the email. But last week when I couldn't find it, I was putting in your name and everything, and usually it comes up. But this last week it didn't come up at all, so I figured you didn't put the link on the email.
I did.
Well, I
Every
could,
Thursday night I send it out.
it wouldn't come up, and I even went through the last few days of email, and I couldn't see it there. So,
It didn't come up this time either, only last week.
oh no, this time also it wasn't up there, but I knew that it would be in Facebook. But I couldn't find it again on the email.
Okay. George is here.
Jordan McCoy.
Right, yeah. He's the only George we have.
Yeah. Well, we have George Santos too, unfortunately.
I know. All right. George, can you hear us? Okay, Bill Podd is coming from England already. That's good. Bill.
You know, George Washington said, "I cannot tell a lie," but George Santos says, "I can't tell the truth."
Right. Well, George, hi, can you hear us? Bill, can you
Yes,
hear
yes.
us? Yeah. Bill, your picture is jumping around a little. Okay, let's see. Okay,
It's got the fidgets.
I have clicking screen.
Hi, everybody. I'm on a lot funny today. I'll have to sort that out.
Right. I might have a jumpy picture, I'm not sure yet, because I'm just using my new laptop and I've been having a bit of trouble with the settings because when I put it on original sounds, it seems to scramble everything. So I've put it back onto my
Well,
lowest interference on audio.
now you're okay. Before
Yeah.
you were jumping.
Yeah. Most likely
Okay.
first night nerd. There we go. Can I just have a quick tootle on this and I'll see if it carries all right before we start talking?
Changing the picture. How about putting us on?
It used to come on. without having to do that.
That sounds fairly normal, or was it scrambled still?
Sounded okay.
Sounded all right. Okay, I won't interfere with any more then.
Where's Hawking, Pat? Let me get permission.
Are we ready to turn the recording on?
1 second. Okay, now you can turn it on.
Thanks.
Okay. I'm jumping again.
Harvey's eyes are so far better than mine, and his computer has print like, you know, this big, and I have print this big, so I can't see the computer. That's why he.
I might just have to stop my video. Hang on.
Mike, you still in Spain yet?
Hello. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
You're still in Spain.
Yeah. Your audio is very bad. Your audio is bad.
No. I won't be singing.
Okay. If you want to move your camera, when you see the top of your head, I don't see your whole head, Mike.
Yeah, your chin is better.
Yeah. Okay. Good.
That's it.
You got it. Okay, let me see. Is everybody?
Could you tell me if my picture is not flashing now?
Yeah, your picture is okay.
It's okay.
Right. It's a certain lights I've got that if I have them on, it flashes.
It was Bill Pardon's picture that was flashing. That was flashing. Okay, we have 11 so far. Let me see.
Bob Winkler, sorry to hear about your horse passing away.
Trying to maintain normal schedule here. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Can't hear you, Bob.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yeah, just trying to maintain a schedule.
That's a good thing to do.
Yeah.
Susan, good to see you back again.
Thank you.
Not 11 so far. I think last week was a record on attendance.
I think so.
It was.
We never went until 5 o'clock before.
I know.
Never.
Not afraid. I don't see her though. She was not like doing it, and then she just dropped out. We have another 6 minutes yet till we start. Let's see who else is coming in. I think Marie said she was going to be here today, and Tony was going to be here. By the way, it's cold down here. For the last 3 days, my steam has been on.
Yeah, yeah. Well, they're having a gathering for the people in our community here today.
A potluck.
And you know, so I don't know how the attendance is going to be there. You know.
Around the pool, no less.
Outdoors.
Yeah.
What is the temperature there now?
It is 59 degrees.
59 degrees.
It started at 47 today.
Yeah. For us this morning, it started at, let's say it was 4 degrees below zero. That would be, 25 in Fahrenheit.
You're kidding.
Isn't it all about Florida?
Well, that's about that north. That's about what we have it in Brooklyn, about 25 degrees. I mean, the real feel, it's, the actual temperature is a little higher, but the real feel is about in the mid-20s.
Yeah, 37 degrees now with the real feel of 26. It's because it's windy. The problem with having a gathering around the pool down here in this kind of weather is that you have to watch out for falling iguanas.
Yes. Right. Yes.
Well, they had the iguana patrol come around the other day. And I don't know exactly what they do with them, but
we have lots of them.
They disperse of the additional iguanas that we don't want here.
That is iguanas, not piranhas, is it?
I think they ship them off to England.
We'll eat anything over
there. What do you do with the alligators?
Those we keep.
Central Park.
Central Park.
The New York sewers.
I thought they belonged down in the sewers.
Yeah.
I do my own alligating.
Donnie, you finally made it. You tried to get in before, you couldn't get in before. Now you're finally in here. We see you.
I've been trying since about 20 till. So I tried three times. So I finally got it after I talked to
difficulty?
You.
What was the difficulty?
It just kept a black screen, kept on going round and round and round, saying connecting. And it wouldn't connect me.
So I hit the button right away when I saw you.
Yeah, I fixed it. Thank you.
You can change our name if you want.
Hi, everyone. Happy New Year.
Hello.
4 more minutes we have till it starts.
It is my understanding that since iguanas are an invasive species.
Yes.
That's you can true. Kill them anytime you want. So that when they gather them up, they may turn them into fish food. I don't actually know. Because they're not supposed to be here in the first place. So the state doesn't mind if you kill them. And they're easy to catch when they're comatose.
You know, the truth is, Harvey, we're not supposed to be here either.
Speak for yourself, if you're a Seminole, you're allowed to be.
That's a Seminole statement.
Ba-dum-bum.
The Seminoles came from further north originally. But they went down to Florida when Andrew Jackson wanted to send them to Oklahoma Territory.
Actually, the Seminoles were here all along. Did you know that the Seminole tribe is the only tribe that never signed a peace treaty with the United States government or gave up? They just retreated into the swamps and kept fighting.
I didn't know that.
Cool.
I didn't know they were the only tribe. I thought the Schmohawks also didn't.
The Schmohawks, that's a Brooklyn tribe, isn't it?
Is that why they were allowed to open their casinos?
No, that's not why. But it is true that they're the only Indian tribe, the only Native nation that never gave up and never signed a peace treaty with the United States. They never stopped fighting.
Hey, let's talk about Jack Abramoff.
Okay, let's give the order. We're ready to start in 1 minute. So everybody have your pencil and paper. Okay, Murray was first. Okay, then we have George. Bill Pop, Kathleen, Bob and Susan, Harvey and Pat, Debbie and Ron, Bob Winkler, Lonnie, Mike Reed, and Donna. Okay, so that's the order for today. If anybody else comes in, we'll put the last on the list.
I told you so, I'm not singing.
What? Mike, you're not singing, Mike. That's why
I am not singing.
Okay, I have you as not singing. Okay, not singing. Okay. Okay, so everybody please mute now. And Maury, are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, everybody please mute. And remember, unmute when you clap, but you have to remute again, otherwise I have to go around muting everybody that didn't unmute, so make my job easier, please. Let's mute. Murray, go ahead.
Okay. All right. This is the book that I'm using today. This is this old one. It was, originally produced in 1916. But then it says that some of the songs there were produced in 1918, although there are a lot of songs earlier than 1916 and 1918 also. But since it says 1918, I figure this must be a second edition of the same book that was originally published in 1916. And it says the most popular songs of patriotism. And then after that, it has a section that includes other national songs of all over the world. Although I notice that there's none from Germany or any troops that any countries that were allied with Germany in the First World War. They nicely neglected them because of the war, I guess. All right. Anyway, the first song is actually a Civil War song, and it was written by a very famous Civil War composer of both words and music, George F. Root, R-O-O-T. And he wrote quite a few Civil War songs that some are even played nowadays because of their lively melodies and marches and all stuff like that. Okay, and this song is the Battle Cry of Freedom. Okay. And sort of it fits in with the fact that today is Martin Luther King's actual birthday. It's also my sister's birthday, but that has nothing to do with it. All right. This is about the Battle Cry of Freedom. It's a Civil War song sung by the Union. Yes, we'll rally round the flag, boys, we'll rally once again, shouting the battle cry of freedom. We will rally from the hillside, we'll rally from the plain, shouting the battle cry of freedom. The Union forever, hurrah, boys, hurrah. Down with the traitor, up with the stars, while we rally round the flag, boys, rally once again, shouting the battle cry of freedom. We are springing to the call of our brothers gone before, shouting the battle cry of freedom. And we'll fill the vacant ranks with a million free men more, shouting the battle cry of freedom. The Union forever, hurrah, boys, hurrah. Down with the traitor, up with the stars, while we rally round the flag, boys, rally once again, shouting the battle cry of freedom. That's it.
Thank you, Murray. And now from New York, we're moving down to Huntsville, Alabama. George, are you ready?
I am.
Okay, so
I have kind of a theme today. I'm going to sing a couple of songs about famous shipwrecks. The first one, it was written by Gordon Lightfoot, and it tells the tale of the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald, which was a large ore freighter on Lake Superior that sank in November of 1975. The legend lives on from the Chippewa on down of the big lake they call Gitche-Gumee. The lake, it is said, never gives up her dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. With a load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. That good ship and true was a bone to be chewed when the gales of November came early. The ship was the pride of the American side, coming back from some mill in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain well seasoned. Concluding some terms with a couple of steel firms when they left fully loaded for Cleveland. And later that night, when the ship's bell rang, could it be the north wind they'd been feeling? The wind in the wires made a tattletale sound, and a wave broke over the railing. And every man knew, as the captain did too, 'twas the witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late, and the breakfast had to wait, when the gales of November came slashing. When afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. When supper time came, the old cook came on deck saying, "Fellas, it's too rough to feed ya." At 7 p.m., the main hatchway caved in. He said, "Fellas, it's been good to know ya." The captain wired in, he had water coming in, and the good ship and crew was in peril. And later that night, when his lights went out of sight, came the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Does anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn the minutes to hours? The searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay if they'd put 15 more miles behind her. They might have split up, or they might have capsized. They may have broke deep and took water. And all that remains is the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. Lake Huron rolls, Superior sings in the rooms of her ice water mansion. Old Michigan steams like a young man's dreams. The islands and bays are for sportsmen. And farther below, Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. And the iron boats go, as the mariners all know, with the gales of November, remember. In a musty old hall in Detroit, they prayed in the Maritime Sailor's Cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. The legend lives on from the Chippewa on down, up the big lake they call Gitche Gumee. Superior, it said, never gives up her dead. When the gales of November come early,
very nice, George.
Well done.
Thank you. Thank you so much, George. And now, Bill Pond, by the way, it looks like you're on the old computer, because when you had the other picture on, it looks like you drank a little too much. You were having the DTs and jumping all over the place.
Right. That could still happen again. If it does, I'll just stop my video midway through. But yes, it's very distracting. So we'll see what happens anyway.
Look, very TikTok.
Oh, don't talk about it. Let's see how we get on with this anyway. There's an old English word called mithering, which means making a fuss and annoying people and getting under their feet and being a nuisance. But that's something that you might need to know if we get that far. Don't come a-mithering me, Jenny. Don't come a-mithering me. I'm going back to sea, Jenny. I'm going back to sea. Stormy weather is squalling, Jenny. Don't come a-mithering me. Seabirds are calling, Jenny. I'm going back to sea. Distant sails are billowing, Jenny. Don't come a-mithering me. To far off lands I'm following, Jenny. I'm going back to sea. Work to do and pain to bear, Jenny. Don't come a-mithering me. And many a danger out there, Jenny. I'm going back to sea. Come some distant day, Jenny. Don't come a-mithering me. You can help me spend me pay, Jenny. I'm going back to sea. You should have chosen a farmer, Jenny. Don't come a-mithering me. A sailor's just a false charmer, Jenny. I'm going back to sea. Don't come a-mithering me, Jenny. Don't come a-mithering me. I'm going back to sea, Jenny. I'm going back to sea. I'm going back to sea, Jenny. I'm going back to sea. Just killing time while I try to get the music back on.
Got a light show along with the music.
Yeah, I'll have to go onto my disco setting and take it off, I think. So.
Okay, thank you so much, Bill. And now, Kathleen, are you ready?
Oh, yes, that was me. Okay. Yeah, glad to see Susan back. And Donna, haven't seen Donna for a long while, have we? Mind you, I think she's disappeared now, has she? Right, she's still there, yeah.
No, she's there.
Yeah. I can only see 12 screens on my iPad, that's the thing. So I have to swipe it. Right, this is a Bob Dylan song. And I think I'd need to borrow a couple of Bill's hats with this one. His boots are Spanish leather. I'm sailing away, my own true love. I'm sailing away in the morning. Is there something I can send you from across the sea? From the place where I'll be landing. There's nothing you can send me, my own true love. There's nothing I am wishing to be owning. Just carry yourself back to me unspoiled. From across that lonesome ocean. Oh, but I just thought you might want something fine, made of silver or of golden, either from the mountains of Madrid, from the coast of Barcelona. If I had the stars of the darkest night, and the diamonds from the deepest ocean, I'd forsake them all for your sweet kiss. For that's all I'm wishing to be owning. Oh, I might be gone a long old time, and it's only that I'm asking. Is there something I can send you to remember me by, to make your time more easy passing? How can you ask me again? Well, it only brings me sorrow, for that same thing I would want today. I would want again tomorrow. Oh, I got a letter on a lonesome day. It was from his ship a-sailing, saying I don't know when I'll be coming back again. It depends on how I'm feeling. Oh, if you, my love, must think that way, I'm sure your mind is a-roaming. I'm sure your thoughts are not with me, but with the country where you're going. So take heed of the western wind. Take heed of stormy weather. And yes, there is
something you can send back to me. Spanish boots of Spanish leather.
Thank you. Thank you, Kathleen. And now from England, back to Point Beach, Florida, Joseph and Bob.
Yes. Well, we're feeling a lot better. I'm still a little stuffed up. But as promised, last week some Ian Tyson songs were done because he had passed away recently. And we had promised that we would do a little Four Strong Winds today. And we are going to do that. I'm using my 1963 Martin here because I got it tuned down a little bit so I can use...
Because we're both singing low right now.
And I can use the chords that I like. Four strong winds that blow lonely, seven seas that run high, all those things that don't change, come what may. But our good times are all gone, and I'm bound for moving on. I look for you if I'm ever back this way. Well, guess I'll go out to Alberta. Weather's good there in the fall. Got some friends that I can go to work and for. Still I wish you'd change your mind if I asked you one more time. But we've been through that 100 times or more. Four strong winds that blow lonely, seven seas that run high, all those things that don't change, come what may. But our good times are all gone, and I'm bound for moving on. I look for you if I'm ever back this way. If I get there before the snow flies, and if things are going good, you could meet me if I sent you down the fair. But by then it would be winter, ain't too much for you to do, and those winds sure can blow cold way out there. Four strong winds that blow lonely, seven seas that run high, all those things that don't change, come what may. But our good times are all gone, and I'm bound for moving on. I look for you if I'm ever back this way. Four strong winds that blow lonely, seven seas that run high, all those things that don't change, come what may. But our good times are all gone, and I'm bound for moving on. I look for you if I'm ever back this way.
Nicely done.
Thank you.
We got one more.
Yeah, I gotta switch lyrics and guitars. Well, because I haven't had much of a voice lately, I haven't really been trying to practice very much and kind of save it. Actually had a gig the other day and I did it, got through it. But I'm going to just do a couple of Tom Paxson songs, well-known ones. You can sing the choruses at home. And of course, Tom just had his 85th birthday. So thinking of him also, and we got to see a radio Zoom a couple of weeks ago where they celebrated Tom's birthday, had a lot of good people on program. He was a man, friend always. He stuck with me through the bad old days. He never cared if I had no dough. We'd ramble around the rain and snow. So here's to you, all your ramble and bring you joy. Here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your ramble and bring you joy. In Tulsa town, we chanced astray. We thought we'd try work one day. The boss said he had room for one. Said my old pal, we'd rather bum. So here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your rambling bring you joy. Here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your rambling bring you joy. Oh, late one night in a jungle camp, the weather is cold and damp. He got the chills and he got them bad. They took the only friend I had. So here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your rambling bring you joy. Here's to you, my rambling boy. All your rambling bring you joy. Oh, he left me here to ramble on. My rambling pal is dead and gone. If when we die we go somewhere, well, I bet you a dollar he's rambling there. So here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your rambling bring you joy. Here's to you, my rambling boy. May all your rambling bring you joy.
One of my favorites.
Okay, and now Harvey and Pat. Are you ready, Pat? Unmute. Still on the muter. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, she had to find her file. Yeah. Always a difficult thing, sometimes painful.
So this song is Drive by the Cars.
Mm-hmm.
gonna tell you when it's too late. Who's gonna tell you things aren't so great? Can't go on thinking nothing's wrong. What now? Who's gonna drive you home tonight? Who's gonna pick you up when you fall? Who's gonna hang you up when you call? Who's gonna pay attention to your dreams? Who's gonna plug the ears when you scream? Nothing's wrong. What now? Who's gonna drive you home tonight. Gonna hold you down when you shake? Who's gonna come around when you break? You can't go on thinking nothing's wrong. Gonna drive you home tonight. Whoa, you know you can't go on thinking nothing's wrong. Who's gonna drive you home tonight? So, because it's very wintry out, minus the snow, of course, out here today, with a temperature that barely breached 60 degrees Fahrenheit, for those Celsius people amongst you, I decided to do a song by Joni Mitchell called Urge for Going, about winter, amazingly enough. I awoke today and found the frost perched on the town. It hovered in a frozen sky and it gobbled summer down. When the sun turns traitor cold, all the trees are shivering in a naked road. Got the urge for going, but I never seem to go. Yes, I get the urge for going when the meadow grass is turning brown, summertime is falling down, winter closing in. Had a girl in summertime, summer colored skin. not another guy in town, my darling's heart could win. When the leaves fell on the ground, bully winds came around and pushed them face down in the snow. Got the urge for going, and I had to let her go. Yeah, she got the urge for going when the winter grass was turning brown, summertime was falling down, winter closing in. Now the warriors of winter, they gave a cold triumphant shout. All that stays is dying, all that lives is getting out. See the leaves, chevron flight, flapping and racing on before the snow. We got the urge for going, if they got the wings to go. Yes, they got for going when meadow grass is turning brown, summertime is falling down, winter closing in. By the fire with kindling now, I'll pull the blankets to my chin. I'll lock the vagrant winter out, and I'll bolt my wanderings in. Like to call back summertime, have her stay for just another month or so. She's got the urge for going, so I guess she'll have to go. Yes, he gets the urge for going when the meadow grass is turning brown, all her empire is falling down, winter closing in. Yes, I get the urge for going when the meadow grass is turning brown, summertime is falling down.
Lovely. And now from Florida up to Queens, Debbie and Rob.
All right. Interesting. We have another sea song here.
Well, I haven't done a sea song in quite some time. It's called Bonnie Ship the Diamond.
Right. Scottish originally.
Yeah, Peterhead is in Scotland, which I sang this song for like for many, many years. Didn't know where Peterhead was. The diamond is rich, the boys bound, and the kids so hard to do before he left town.
And the jacket is so the blue. When we return to Peterhead, All right, now we got a couple of songs today. I'll do Martin, thinking of Martin Luther King's birthday. So I'm going to sing one that's much older than, you know, the civil rights movement of the 60s. And this was actually first published in 1928. let's see, what key am I in? All right, and you're probably familiar with it. The Weavers did it long ago. Okay. Again, huh? I love
fun.
Drinking gourd, by the way, is the Big Dipper, and it's generally in the northern sky.
Right, so, and the slaves were following it in the Underground Railroads.
Yeah, fleeing at night to the north.
Yeah.
To follow the drinking gourd.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you so much, Debbie and Ron. And now out to west to Oregon, Bob Winkler.
Good to be here. I wasn't too sure I was going to be today. Excuse me. As some of you might know, we lost our beautiful 26-year-old Morgan horse yesterday. He colicked yesterday morning, which is gut pain. Ended up having a fatty lymphoma on his lower intestine, and we had him humanely euthanized over at Oregon State University Veterinary Hospital in Corvallis. So yesterday evening, very long day, very hard emotionally. Anyway, so you see me looking over here on the screen. I'm just looking at my other two Morgan horses over in Turner, the next town, being taken care of by my niece, where they're housed. So anyway, I totally redid the songs I was going to do, and so the songs, two songs I do this morning are going to be dedicated to Studs. So the first one is going to be a Diamond Rio song that I know I've done before, but my voice is pretty terrible here. Anyway. Does it sound okay? Always have to ask.
Yes, it is.
Try to get through it. First line is true. Last night I had a crazy dream. A wish was granted just for me, could be for anything. I didn't ask for money or a mansion in Malibu. I simply wished one more day with you. One more day, one more time. One more sunset, maybe I'd be satisfied. But then again, I know what I would do. Leave me wishing still one more day with you. One more day. First thing I do is pray for time to crawl, unplug the telephone and keep the TV off. I'd hold you every second, say a million I love yous. That's what I do. One more day with you. One more day. One more time. before sunset. Maybe I'd be satisfied. But then again, I know what I'd do. Leave me wishing still for one more day with you. Leave me wishing still one more day leave me wishing still
Lovely. So sorry for your loss, Lonnie.
It's the audience so buff. Okay, by the way, Donna, it was Bob who lost the horse, not Lonnie. It was Bob. Just saying, yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. I get the names confused sometimes.
Bob who lost the horse, yeah.
Okay. Bob, what's your last name?
Winkler.
Bob Winkler. Okay.
You can read it.
Yes, okay.
And now it's Bonnie's turn from the Ocala National Forest where it's cold, right?
Sure is. Yes, it is. Bob, I know where, I know exactly how you feel. In my world, the animals are always more important than anyone else. So sympathy from here to you. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and do a sea song that is about whales. Not the country, but the animal. You can hear them in the background there.
There were men who would boil on the sea, the perils of death on their faces. They sailed from their harbors all vowing to be traditionally bound to their places. From Finland and Norway, from Sweden and Spain, from Denmark and Russia came many. To brave the great depths of Leviathan's raid, where blubber and oil were plenty. And the vessels became known as factories, and the lances were loaded with charges. And the challenge was lost in the blast of the seas, bloodied the processing barges. And it's gone, 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 all of me. Traditional whaling is over, all away, all away. And it's gone, 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 all of me. Hardies, haul away. On the waters up north, the prey came to feed on the plankton they gathered for my holt. The baleen and blues and grays came to breed with their crooked and waterlogged smiles. The captains and maids would call, "There she blows!" The giants exploded with geysers, and the raging would surge at the hot-blooded throes from marksmen and crow's nest advisors. But the vessels became known as factories, and the harpoons were loaded with charges. The challenge was lost in the blast of the seas, bloodied the processing barges. And it's gone, 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 all the way. Traditional whaling is over, all the way, all the way. And it's gone, 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 all the way. Well, once there were men who would die on the sea, pursuing the great spermaceti, whose blubber and bone and oil would be transported through each home for jetty. And many a song would be sung on the prow, where the rum poured more than a morsel, and groggy and mustard to spill on the bow, the toast lifted up to the dorsal. And the vessels became known as factories, and the harpoons were loaded with charges. And the challenge was lost in the blast of the seas that bloodied the processing barges. And it's gone, 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 all the way. Traditional whaling is over, all the way, all the way. While the crew would rail at the sight of a breach, and the fluke would wave in the diving, not a chance would allow them to reach the distance the keel would be driving. And the waters would foam, and a boat would be thrown in the tempest unleashed for the oil. For brave men alone with the weapons they own would tackle the black blood they boiled. But the vessels became known as factories, and the harpoons were loaded with charges. And the challenge was lost in the blast of the seas that bloodied the processing barges. And it's gone, 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 all the way. Traditional whaling is over, all the way, all the way. And it's gone, 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 all the way, all the way.
Dennis Hines.
Yeah, gone, gone, gone. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Ronnie. And now, North Florida, back to South Florida. Donna, unless you're in Canada, where are you, Donna?
No, I'm in Florida.
In Florida, okay.
Thankfully, we've been in the 40s and 50s lately, but it's coming back up to 80 on Wednesday. So, in honor of Martin Luther King's Day, I'd like to go ahead and extol this book here, The Water Dancer by Ta-Nehisi. It's a Oprah Winfrey book club from 2006, and it's about a slave boy, and it's wonderful. I mean, it's so well written, and it just shows the life of this fella. I'm telling you, it's a good book, The Water Dancer, if anybody's interested. I did If I Had a Hammer for Fern Forest last week. I'm not going to do it again now. I'm just going to do this one. What do I do with my capo? Oh, here it is. Okay. I was at a fair some years ago, and there was a booth about the environment and all this and the ocean. And I gave them my card, and they said, "Oh, you're a songwriter. Can you write a song for us?" And I said, "I don't know." I said, "They're inspired. I'll see what I can do." I got in my car going to my dad's in Fort Lauderdale, and I sent up a little prayer, "Lord, if you got a song for it, please let me know." And as I'm in the middle of 95, the words just flooded me. And I said, "Not now, thank you." And at 7:30 that night when I got home, I said, "Okay, Lord, now." So this song is called All the Creation Cries Out, and it's still crying out. We still have to do more. And help the animals. I'm going to do the wild horse song later on, and we're just not doing what we're supposed to do. So everybody try. I'm not using laundry soap anymore. I use the little sheets from one of the green companies. They're just a sheet. They work great. Anyway, here it is. All of creation cries out, all of creation cries to you and me. From every bird that's nesting, from every turtle hatching, from every wave that crashes from the sea. We have a plan that frees us, we have a way that feeds us, all of creation greets us tenderly. It's up to you. Bit by bit, take more and more, cement the sand, destroy the shore, the gold that glitters, that's the lure. How, what's the use? There's nothing more, there's nothing more. All of creation calls out, all of creation cries out, all of creation cries to you and me. From every horse that's grazing, from every turtle nesting, from every wave that crashes from the sea. We have a plan that frees us, we have a way that feeds us, all of creation greets us tenderly. It's up to you and me. Bit by bit, take more and more, cement the sand, destroy the shore, the gold glitters, that's the lure. How, what's the use? There's nothing more, there's nothing more. All of creation cries out, all of creation cries out, all of creation cries to you and me. From every wave that crashes from the sea, it's up to you and me. Protect the land and shore, also use a bamboo toilet paper from a company called whogivesacrap.com. Please go to whogivesacrap.com and get your bamboo toilet paper. It's great. And it send you 48 of them at a time. I got 48 coming every 6 months.
Thank you.
Thank you. Rules come one on top of the other. Do the rolls come one on top of the other like a piece of bamboo?
Yeah. Oh, hold on. Marty, let me show you something. Here they are. They're all wrapped in paper for you. Look at that. You can give them as gifts. And they're nice and soft. Whogivesacrap.com.
Thank you. Thank you for the commercial. Doreen, are you ready for us?
Yeah.
Okay, great to you.
Well, you know, I'm new here, so, you know, I want to fit in, and there's lots of songs about ships and rambling boys, and so I'm going to sing the Ramblin' Sailor. Oh, I am a sailor, brisk and bold, and oft-times sail the ocean. I've traveled the country far and near for honor and promotion. My shipmates, all I bid you adieu, I may no longer go along with you. I'll travel the country through, and they call me the Ramblin' Sailor. And if you want to know my name it is Young Johnson. I've got a commission from the king to court all girls is handsome. With my false heart and flattering tongue, I court them all, both old and young. I'll court them all, but I'll marry none, and they call me the Ramblin' Sailor. Well, first I come to Plymouth town, and there were lasses many. I boldly stepped up to a one to court her for her money. Says I, me dear, be of good cheer, I will not leave you, do not fear. I'll travel the country far and near, and they'll call me the Ramblin' Sailor. And next I come to Portsmouth town, and there were lasses plenty. I boldly stepped up to a one to court her for her beauty. Says I, me dear, what do you choose? There's ale and a wine and a rum punch too, besides a pair of silks and shoes, if you'll travel with the Ramblin' Sailor. And then I rose up with the dawn just as the day was peeping. On tiptoe down the stairs I went, and I left my love a-sleeping. And if she wakes, if she waits until I come, she may lie there till the day of her doom. I'll court some other girl in her room, and they call me the Ramblin' Sailor. That's it.
Very good, Darren.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Doreen. And I hope you'll be a regular here every week.
Yeah.
You fit right in with ever, so don't worry. Whatever you sing, we're happy with it. Okay. Last week, I did a polka, which I didn't know whether it would fit in with our folklore, but apparently it was very popular and people liked it. So what we're going to do is we're going to try another one. This is the granddaddy of all polkas. It's called the Beer Barrel Polka. Goes like this. There's a garden, what a garden, only happy faces bloom there, and there's never any room there for a worry or a bloom there. Oh, there's music, and there's dancing, and a lot of sweet romancing. When they play the polka, they all get in the swing. Every time they hear the um-pa-pa, everybody feels so tra-la-la. They want to throw their cares away. They all go la-da-da-dee-day. Then they hear a rumble on the floor. It's the big surprise they're waiting for. And all the couples form a ring. For miles around, you'll hear them sing. Roll out the barrel, we'll have a barrel of fun. Roll out the barrel, We've got the blues on the run. Zing, boom, ta-ra-ra. Sing out a song of good cheer. Now's the time to roll the barrel for the gang's all here. Then they hear a rumble on the floor. It's the big surprise they're waiting for. And all the couples form a ring. For miles around, you'll hear them sing. If you know what singing would be, roll out the barrel. We'll have a barrel of fun. Roll out the barrel. We've got the blues on the run. Zing, boom, ta-ra-ra. Sing out a song of good cheer. Now's the time to roll the barrel for the gangs all here.
Bravo!
Dobrze, dobrze, dobrze. Dziękuję pan.
That was great.
Okay, so we've completed one round trip, as they say, and we're ready to go for the second round. So everybody please mute. And Murray, you have the floor.
Okay, except you didn't hear from Laura's mother whether she wants to sing or not.
If she is, she would tell me.
Okay. All right. So
she's not there. Laura's just going to listen today.
Yeah.
I knew that in advance. Okay.
All right, so I'll go ahead. All right, I'm going to sing a song, one of whose versions I sang before, maybe once or twice. But when I was looking through this book again, I found another version of it that I had never seen before. And actually, it's another version of the song, "The Girl I Left Behind Me." Now, I've sung a version of it that went back to the Civil War. I've sang a version of it that I sang a version of it that was among the Cowboys songs. And I think every outdoor occupation that somebody had, they made another version of "The Girl I Left Behind Me." But anyway, this one, I don't know when it was written. It doesn't give any date for when it was produced. I think because it's sort of a folk song by now, because they don't know who was the original one, as far as I see here, who was the original one who sang either the melody or the song or the words. But all right, we know it. This version goes back at least to 1918 or 1916, the time of the First World War. But of course, it has nothing to do with the war. All right. Okay, here we go. I'm lonesome since I crossed the hill and o'er moor and valley, such heavy thoughts my heart to fill since parting with my Sally. I'll seek no more the fine and gay, for each does but remind me how swift the hours did pass away with a girl I left behind me. Oh, never shall I forget that night. The stars were bright above me and gently lent their silvery light when first she vowed she loved me. But now I'm bound to Brighton camp. Kind heaven may favor bind me and send me safely back again to the girl I left behind me. The bee shall honey taste no more, the dove becomes a ranger, the dashing waves shall cease no more, for she's to me a stranger. The vows were registered above shall never cheer and bind, shall ever cheer and bind me in constancy to her I love, the girl I left behind me. My mind her form shall still retain in sleeping or in walking until I see my love again, whom my heart is breaking. If ever I should see the day when Mar shall have resigned me, forevermore I'll gladly stay with the girl I left behind me. The sweet little girl, the pretty little girl, the girl I left behind me. Forevermore I'll gladly stay with the girl I left behind me.
No, I don't know that version.
Thank you, Pastor Murray. Now, somebody just say something to Murray? Apparently not. Okay, so we're going from Brooklyn now down back to Alabama, Huntsville, Alabama. George McCoy, take it away, George.
This is another song about a sea disaster. It was also written by Gordon Lightfoot in 1966, I believe. On November 13th, 1965, the Yarmouth Castle, a liner that ran between Miami and Nassau, did overnight excursions, caught fire and sank with the loss of over 90 lives. This is the story of that tragic night. Well, it's 4 o'clock in the afternoon, the anchors have been weighed. From Miami to Nassau, she's bound across the waves. She's a-heading south through Biscayne Bay into the open sea. The Yarmouth Castle, she's a-dying, don't know it. Now the many years she's been to sea, she's seen better times. She gives a groan of protest as they cast away her line. And the grumble of her engines and the rust along her spine tells the castle she's too old to be sailing. But the sands run out within her heart, a tiny spark glows red. It smolders through the evening, there's laughter overhead. Now the men are served and the cards are dealt and the drinks are passed around. Deep within the fire starts burning. Now it's midnight on the open sea and the moon is shining bright. Some people join the party and others say goodnight. Well, there's many who are sleeping now, it's been a busy day. And a tiny wisp of smoke is rising. Oh Lord, she groans, I'm burning, let someone understand. But her silent plea is wasted in the playing of the band. Everybody's dancing on her deck and they're having such a time. Then a voice says, shut up and deal, I'm losing. Deep within the Yarmouth Castle, a fire begins to glow. Leaps into the hallways and climbs and twists and grows. And the paint she wore to keep her young, oh Lord, how well it burns. And soon that old fire is raging. Up beneath the bridge it's climbing fast, the captain stands aloft. He calls up to the bosun, says, bosun, we're lost. For the ragged hoses in the racks, no pressure do they hold. And the people down below will soon be dying. All amidships, oh, she's blazing now, it's spreading fore and aft. The people are scrambling as the fire blocks their path. The evil smoke surrounds them and they're falling in their tracks. And the captain in his lifeboat is leaving. Oh, then the ship Bahama Star comes steaming through the night. She sees the castle blazing, and 'tis a terrible sight. Jump down, her captain cries, we'll save you if we can. Then the paint on his funnels is a-frying. God help the ones who sleep below and cannot find the way. Thank God for those we rescue upon this awful day. Now the heroes, they are many, but the times are growing slim. And now from stern to bow, she's a-blazing. For the Yarmouth Castle's moaning, she's crying like a child. You can hear her if you listen above the roar so wild. Is she crying for the ones who lie within her molten sides? Or crying for herself, I'm a-wondering. But the living soon were rescued, the ones who lived to tell. From the star they watched her as she died there in the swells. Like a toy ship on a mill pond, she burned all through the night. Then slipped beneath the waves in the morning.
I've never heard that one before. That's a real beautiful song.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, George. Okay, now who's next?
Bill.
Or Bill, are you ready? So you have your hat ready?
Okay. Well, I'm back on my old steam-driven laptop, so anything could happen. My supercomputer new one, I've just given up the ghost on. And yes, you may have noticed I'm wearing a hat. This is a narrator's hat, which will be obvious in a little while. But strange things have happened. This week I've spoken to Karen, who now follows the recordings week by week. And she mentioned the fact, and Kathleen earlier on said she could do with some of my hats. So I wasn't going to do this, but I thought the gods are bidding it. I'm going to have to do one of my hat songs. So, George, if you find that I'm getting very confused and mixed up and stuttering on my lines and everything else, it's because I keep changing hats depending on the character, and I normally get it wrong. And if I don't get it wrong, I forget the words anyway. So we shall see. But yes, I'm wearing the narrator's hat because this is a story for all you young girls out there who I can see in all the little boxes, not to be swayed by the glamour of a uniform. It can get you into all sorts of trouble. So that's the narration thing just about finished, because suddenly I'm Billy, he says, if I can remember the first line. So Sally, where are you going? That you do look so gay. I know that I'm not asking you to take a walk today. You have not asked me, well indeed, that's a tidy cheek of you. Do you think that there's no more young chaps? Well, I got a dozen or two. So Billy, don't you weep for me. I am going to St. James's Park, me cousin Joe to see. Oh, cousin Joe, now who is he? He's a soldier, I can tell, for I know you're keen on lobster, both raw and cooked as well. Me cousin Joe's a guardsman, and he is a handsome chap, and he wears a fine mustachio and a stunning furry cap. So, Billy, don't you weep for me. I am very fond of Cousin Joe, and he's very fond of me. In fact, we're going to a play tonight, Jack Shepherd for to see. And when that it is all over, we'll all have a jolly good spree. I got money for a pint of stout, and when we're short of tin, I'll even go and pawn me smock to buy us a bottle of gin. So, Billy, don't you weep for me. I am going after Cousin Joe, and I'll sit all on his knee.
Well, ask what is the use of him? He never can keep you. You'll have to work from morn till night. That's what you'll have to do. And make sure to the penny each, or else stand at the tub. And mark my words, there's many a day he'll go where he's sure to grub. Then, Sally, you'll cry for me. But go on back to Cousin Joe and I sit all on his knee. Well, in about 12 months after, young Sally came back to me. She said that she was sorry that she'd ever been on that spree. She wanted me to take her back, said I, 'tis no go. Just think that I'm such a fool, you go back to Cousin Joe. And Sally, I can't come over, for I see you have a baby too. A dance all on your knee. Oh, Billy, how can you serve me so? You really drive me mad. I'll have you up before the beacon, I'll swear you are its dad. And when you get before the bench, they will not let you speak. And you'll have to keep the young one on 30 pence a week. So, Billy, how could you serve me so? I'm sure the child belongs to you and not to Cousin Joe.
I don't know. I think this time round, I think I'm the narrator, but you'll have to make do with Billy if I can't find his. Now, hang on. Yes. We're right. We're the narrator. So it says, well, in a week she gets this summons. She found it was no go. The magistrate decided that the child belonged to Joe. But she went up to Billy's backyard and quickly the door she shut. And when at last they found her, she drowned in the water. But so young women, take this warning from me. Never love a soldier or sit all on his knee. Never trust a soldier, girls, there's bullets in his gun. He'll be standing to attention when he offers you some fun. He will up and leave you just as quickly as he can. And never trust a soldier, girl, as long as he's a man. Never trust a sailor, he'll tie you up in knots. He'll bring you back a souvenir that gives you lots of spots. But he will up and leave you just as quickly as he can. Never trust a sailor, girls, as long as he's a man. Or a blacksmith, or a farmer, or a banker, or his clerk. He'll lead you up the garden path and keep you in the dark. But he will up and leave you just as quickly as he can. So never trust a man, girls, as long as he's a man. God bless you.
Okay, now Kathleen.
All right, it's me. Okay. When I sing along with all these different songs, I think, oh, I can't remember the tune I'm going to sing now, so I hope I remember it. It's Kate Wolf, and it's called Muddy Roads, and it was written in 1979. So I hope I get the tune right. If I claimed to have the answers, would I be taking chances loving you? If I could say the wind was right, I shouldn't stay with you tonight. Who would lose? 'Cause you got me dancing down these muddy roads, with soft sand between my toes, feeling fine. Sunlight playing on my back, shirt in hand, singing out in crazy rhyme. And if I could see around the bend, would it change the time I spend wanting you? If I could bring you a perfect rose from all the pretty buds that grow, how could I choose? 'Cause you got me dancing down these muddy roads with soft sand between my toes, feeling fine. Sunlight playing on my back, shirt in hand, singing out in crazy rhyme. If I could count the days to come and mark them off one by one to spend with you, I'd be rich but never poor. I'd give myself many more than I could choose. But you've got me dancing down these muddy roads, soft sand between my toes, feeling fine. Sunlight playing on my back, shirt in hand, singing out in crazy rhyme.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Kathleen. Well, no, the Gelbs are next, but all of a sudden they dropped out. And I was hoping they'd come back before their next. So anyway, what we'll do is we'll skip them. We'll go to Javi and Pat. And if the Gelbs come back, we'll take them right after Javi and Pat. But right now, Pat and Javi, you're on. Unmute, please. Pat, unmute. Unmute. Okay, you're good.
Did you unmute like he asked you to?
I am unmuted.
Okay.
You're unmuted.
All right, we're good. All right. This song is Lonely People by America. This is for all the lonely people, thinking that life has passed them by. Don't give up until you drink from the silver cup by that highway in the sky. This is for all the single people, thinking that love has left them by.
Very good.
That was great. That was great. We got one more.
Well, as people who are familiar with my song selections know, I really can't do an entire session of purely straight, serious songs. So this was a song written by Mason Williams in an attempt to make an archetypical country and western song. And it's called "You Done Stomped on My Heart." I told you that I loved you, and you said that is good. I called you my darling, I thought I always would. But now you've gone and left me, and I don't know where you're at. You done stomped on my heart and squashed that sucker flat. You done stomped on my heart, you broke it all apart. Sweetheart, you just sorta stomped on my aorta. You started going out with guys, I felt us drift apart. And every step you took was a stomp upon my heart. I only hope that someday, when you have got the blues, in some lonesome room, you look down at your shoes and think about that tender heart you crushed beneath the soul. When your young body craves good times and fancy clothes, you done stomped on my heart, you broke it all apart. Sweetheart, you disorder stomped on my aorta. You started going out with guys, I felt us drift apart. And every step you took was a stomp upon my heart. And every step you took was a stomp upon my heart.
Right on that last note.
Great. And now Bob and Susan came in just in time to take their turn.
I don't know what happened. All of a sudden, it just went out. Zoom just went out.
Yeah. Off. Never happened before. So I'm going to try a little something here. I'm still very froggy, but whatever. There's been a lot of losses lately, you know. Last week we were talking about Ian Tyson and our friends Joe and Ed that went on before us, and my cousin Ronnie passed away. Well, there's just been a lot of losses, and this song helps me get through them, so I hope I can get through it. I am looking at a witch hazel blooming in a garden. Bright yellow flowers in the middle of winter time. And I tell my heart be strong like the witch hazel flower, and you will not be injured by these dark and troubled times. Oh, I take myself away to a place I know in winter, and look at that south shining slope all covered in ice. I remind my heart it all will melt and run down to the ocean. And you will not be injured by these dark and troubled times. We must say goodbye to ones we love. We must say goodbye to many, and we must say goodbye again in way too short a time. But I tell my heart be strong like the witch hazel flower, and you will not be injured by these dark and troubled times, and you will not be injured by these dark and troubled times.
Very nice, son.
Thank you. Very nice.
Okay, well, I had promised you another Tom Paxton song, and we're going to do one. And you'll know the chorus to this. If you don't, pick it up real easy. And Ron always loves my tuning here. I'm playing in C, capoed up on the first fret. It's a long and dusty road, it's a hot and heavy load. Folks I meet ain't always kind. Some are bad and some are good, some have done the best they could, some have tried to ease my troubling mind. And I can't help but wonder, doing the best I can, trying to find what I was meant to do. And the faces that I see look as worried as can be. Looks like they are wondering too. And I can't help but wonder where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Buddy way back home, but he started out to roam. I hear that he's out by Frisco Bay. And sometime when I've had a few, his old words come ringing through. Going out to see him some old day. And I can't help but wonder where I'm bound, where I'm bound. And I had me a girl one time, she had lips like sherry wine. Oh, she loved me till my head went plumb insane. But I was too blind to see that she was slipping away from me. And that good girl ran off on a morning train. And I can't help but wonder where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Can't help but wonder where I'm bound. So if you see me passing by and you sit and you wonder why, you're wishing that you were rambling too. Just nail your shoes to the kitchen floor, lace them up and bar the door. Thank you stars for the roof that's over you. And I can't help but wonder where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Can't help but wonder where I'm bound. I can't help but wonder where I'm bound, where I'm bound. Can't help but wonder where I'm bound.
Donna, can you hear? She just sent me a message that she can't hear. Can you hear us, Donna? Apparently she can't hear us.
Right. That's Earth's thing, not ours.
Okay, so I think Debbie and Rod.
It's because of all the iguanas falling out of the trees down here in Florida.
She only has 4% left on her battery, so she's going to have to leave. She's sorry. But she's using too much juice. It's her problem on there. Okay, Rod and Debbie, you're all set right. to go.
Out here. Jeez.
All right. Well, I can't say that I'm surprised that Bob was singing in C sharp. I know he does that just to make me look bad.
It's all right, but we had some good mandolin going here behind you.
I must admit I'm shocked. Shocked, I say, and utterly dismayed that Harvey has abandoned his usual gravitas to make fun of country music. This is astonishing.
You just got to live in astonishment.
Wait, what? Say that again.
You're just going to have to learn to live with your astonishment.
You were mine for just a while, now you're putting on style, and you never once looked back to your home across the track. You're the gossip of the town, but my heart can still be found where you tossed it on the ground. Pick me up on your way down. Pick me up on your way down when you're blue and all alone. When their glamour starts to bore you, come on back where you belong. You may be their pride and joy, but I'll find another boy and they'll take away your crown. Pick me up on your way down.
Time since I heard that one.
That's some serious country singing.
That's serious. That's right.
That's right. Yes, take that.
Harlan Howard there, 1958. Okay.
Well, you knew that.
I knew that. Okay. All right. So now, so this song was being done when Martin Luther King was out there making his speeches. Anyhow, this was originally actually from 1947, but new verses were added in the 60s during our civil rights movement. Oh my goodness, trying not to cough here. It's called Hallelujah, I'm a Traveling. He's on the bass here. I don't, can you?
Don't worry about it. As long as I can hear it.
All right. Can you hear it? See it.
Why add insult to injury? Right, they can well, hear.
Ah, okay.
Stand up and rejoice. A great day is here. We are fighting Jim Crow and the victory is near. Hallelujah, I'm a traveling. Hallelujah, ain't it fine? Hallelujah, I'm a traveling.
From the Freedom Riders, the 60s.
Now back to Aragon, Bob Winkler.
There we go. Couldn't seem to unmute it there first. Okay, so the second part, the second song is called Morganize, which I wrote back in 2007 for our two Morgan horses. We had two at the time. For Studley and Skyboy, or Skyboy and Studley. I've been watching Skyboy this morning. He's been, just woke up from his nap and has been enjoying his mid-morning snack of hay. So anyway, the first part of this song refers, the whole thing refers to us going riding down in Arizona, where we used to live. And the first part of it refers to Skyboy, the first two verses, the second two refers to Studley and my wife, her going riding. So anyway, it's Morgan Eyes, and used to perform this with my group Angel Wings back in the day. And watches for the time he knows will come when the cowboy will take him riding off into the morning sun, and together horse and rider move as one beneath the sky. That Palomino, oh, he's a flying to see the world through Morgan eyes. He's flying high on the wind, manes aflow and heads held high. Oh, see them run across the fields, stepping high with Morgan pride. This one's for Terry. The woman she nears, he sees her a-coming, lets out his call, turns to the side. He waits by the gate, knowing that he soon will be walking down that dusty trail. He eagerly awaits the bit and the saddle, head to the wind, trail to the sky. The chestnut and the woman, they'll soon be a-riding, seeing this old world through Morgan eyes. They're flying high on the wind, manes aflow, their heads held high. We'll see them run across the field, stepping high with Morgan pride. They're stepping high with Morgan pride. Morgan pride.
Good job, Bob.
Sweet.
Great song.
Thank you, Bob. And now, Lonnie.
I'm here. We're having a wonderful, well, not we, but yeah, we. We're having a wonderful war over in Ukraine. And war songs are, God, there's a lot of them. And here's one of them. It's called No Borderline. I'm standing in the station, I am waiting for a train to take me to the border and my loved one far away. I watched a bunch of soldiers heading for the war. I could hardly even bear to see them go. Rolling through the countryside, tears are in my eyes. We're coming to the borderline, I'm ready with my lights. And in the early morning rain, I'd see her there.
and I know I'll have to say goodbye again. And it's breaking my heart. I know what I must do. I hear my country call me, but I wanna be with you. I'm taking my side. One of us will lose. Don't let go. I wanna know that you will wait for me until the day. There's no border line, no border line. Walking past the border guards, reaching for her hand, showing no emotion, I wanna break into a run. But these are only boys, and I will never know how men can see the wisdom in a war. It's breaking my heart. I know what I must do. I hear my country call me, but I wanna be with you. I'm taking my side. One of us will lose. Don't let go. I wanna know that you will wait for me until the day. There's no border line, no border line. And it's breaking my heart. I know what I must do. I hear my country call me, but I wanna be with you. I'm taking my side. One of us will lose. Don't let go. I wanna know that you will wait for me until the day. There's no border line, no border line.
Nice line.
Amazing. Great, great, great. Powerful. Beautiful. Very powerful. So, thank you so much, Lonnie. Okay, and Donna's not here. We go straight to Doreen.
So, when I was in high school, you know, we learned that Martin Luther King was assassinated. And, you know, I grew up in Chicago, so, you know, very segregated kind of high school, even. But that broke. I was just a crack, and everybody started to get to know each other and talk with one another. It was wonderful. And then I went off to undergraduate school, and I met this woman, African-American woman from Chicago, who taught me guitar, Jan Coleman, and she and I talked about our parents and what we were taught. It was just amazing. So years go by, career. And then Marie and I recently went to Carnegie Hall to listen to Rhiannon Giddens, and she
Your voice just quit. Turn up your volume, your vocals.
Okay. It's at 100. I don't know. Is it better now?
Yeah, that's good.
All right. So anyway, we went, Marie and I went to Carnegie Hall, and we listened to Native Daughters, and there's a woman, Amethyst Kia, who sang this song, Black Myself, and it really, I just think it's, I just was taken by it. So I'm going to sing it now. I want to jump the fence and wash my face in the creek, but I'm black myself. I want to sweep that girl right off of her feet, but I'm black myself. Tired of walking round with no shoes on, but I'm black myself. And your precious God ain't gonna bless me, cause I'm black myself. Is you washed in the blood of your chattel, cause the lambs rotted away? When they stopped shipping workhorses, they bred their own anyway. Ooh. I don't pass the test of the paper bag, cause I'm black myself. I pick the banjo up and they sneer at me, cause I'm black myself. You better lock your doors when I walk by, cause I'm black myself. You look me in my eyes, but you don't see me, cause I'm black myself. Is you washed in the blood of your chattel, cause the lambs rotted away? When they stopped shipping workhorses, they bred their own anyway. Ooh. I don't creep around, I stand proud and free, cause I'm black myself. I go anywhere that I want to go, cause I'm black myself. I'm surrounded by many loving arms, cause I'm black myself. And I'll stand my ground and smile in your face, cause I'm black myself. I've washed away my blood and tears. I've been born brand new. There's no more workhorses, but there's some work to do. Cause I'm black myself, black myself.
Oh,
woo!
That's a good song.
Like it too.
Okay, we're coming to the end now. I'm gonna do one then, being Jerry isn't here, and Anna and Ray aren't here, so. Debbie and Ron, you're going to do the ultimate after I do the penultimate. Agreed?
All right.
Okay. You have time to think of the song while I do mine. Okay, this is a song which is, I believe it's a John Prine song, but it was recorded actually by Nancy Griffith. And if you look on YouTube, there's a recording of the two of them singing a duet on it. It's called The Speed of the Sound of Loneliness. You come home late and you come home early. You come on big when you're feeling small. You come home straight and you come home curly. Sometimes you don't come home at all. So what in the world's come over you? And what in heaven's name have you done? You've broken the speed of the sound of loneliness. You're out there running just to be on the run. Well, I got a heart that burns with a fever, and I got a worried and a jealous mind. How can a love that last forever? Yes, left so far behind. And what in the world's come over you? And what in heaven's name have you done? You've broken the speed of the sound of loneliness. You're out there running just to be on the run. It's a mighty mean and a dreadful sorrow. It's crossed the evil line today. Well, how can you ask about tomorrow? We ain't got one word to say. So what in the world's come over you? And what in heaven's name have you done? You've broken the speed of the sound of loneliness. You're out there running just to be on the run. You're out there running just to be on the run. You're out there running just to be on the run. John Prine.
First time I've heard that one.
We come to the end of a whole session, and we really love everybody. It's getting better every week. I mean, I'm really happy of those who participate, those who even come to listen. I mean, we love you all. We hope, let's let this continue, okay? I never wanted to end. Debbie and Ron, take us out.
All right, wait a minute. Before we do, I have a brief request. I'm finally back to normal. I've calmed down, but we're taking up a collection to refill my astonishment extinguisher after after Harvey's.
All right, hush. All right, so good night all, and this is, you will all sing along to this.
Afternoon. I want to thank everybody who came, and we'll see you all next week. Same login number, same time, same station. Good night, everybody, and drive carefully.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night, everybody.
Debbie and Ron, you coming down to Florida or what?
We hope so. By the beginning of February, we hope now.
Okay.
Yay. We'll let you all know when we're down there.
People get ready. We'll come to Florida.
Thank you, Saul. Thank you, Faye.
We'll drum up some warm weather for you when you come.
Oh, yeah. Even if it's cold there, it's not as cold as here. It's dreadful.
It'll warm up by the time you get here.
See you guys. Well,
see you next week.
Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Bye-bye.
Bye.